Ladies and gentlemen, happy 10-year anniversary for GTA 5. Now, technically, today is not the exact day. We have the GTA story mode that's like 10 years, and then GTA Online's a little bit later, and yada, yada, yada. But this is the update that supposedly was supposed to be for our 10-year, and they have given us quite a lot, including what you can see right here behind me. We are here. It is HANGAR week, as well as a few other businesses that you can make some really, really good money on this week. But for me, my favorite is this right here, the HANGAR. And in this video, I'm going to be walking you through it, showing you everything you need to know, what location you should buy your HANGAR in, what you should source so that you can make the most amount of money, the fastest, easiest way to do this, and then we'll sell it in a public lobby and show you exactly how much money you can make. So first things first, let's go over location. Where should you purchase your HANGAR? So if you want to buy one, you need to go into foreclosure banks, and then you're going to go to HANGARs right here. Now, you can go down here on the bottom. Now, they're not on sale this week, but honestly, your first sale, you're gonna make way more money than it costs to buy it. So even though they're not on sale, just go ahead and buy one. Now, I would never get these unless you're using it just for storage and you're not planning on using this as a business. I would stay away from those. The ones you should definitely buy is one of these three right here. The reason for that is most of the sale missions and source missions are gonna be around this like circle right here. Now, there is gonna be a few source missions, especially with the ground source missions, which are the ones we're gonna do, but I'll talk about that a little bit more here in a second. So there is gonna be a few down here, but that's fine. But this location is just much better for that reason, the cell mission, the source missions, and also you can fly over this without having to worry about going all the way around it. You'll be able to fly over it, no problem. Now, which HANGAR should you buy? There's the first one right here, 3499, which is the most expensive. Technically, it looks like it's the biggest, but it's the exact same size. And that's going to be $2,650,000. Then next up, we have the A2 right here. This one, oh, actually, no, this one is the one that's supposed to be the biggest. Yeah, look at it. It's like, oh, I want this one. It's the biggest one. No, it's exactly the same size. Don't worry about it. This one's $3.2 million. I wouldn't get it, and I didn't get it, because this is the one that I would recommend. It's the cheapest. And there's just no reason. I actually prefer this one so I can just run over. It's just better. It's just better. You can choose whichever one you want. I would choose one of these three. This is the one that I chose. Now, as far as renovations are concerned, the HANGAR style, it's just going to be cosmetic. Lighting is just cosmetic. Floor graphics, same thing, cosmetic. Office furniture is just cosmetic. Living quarters, I would definitely purchase just so you can fast travel to this location. It'll just make your life a lot easier. And also workshop. You don't need a workshop, in all honesty. You can buy it if you want. You don't need it, but if you want it, go ahead and buy it. So that's what I would do. I would purchase this one right here if it was me, and it is me, and that's what I've done. And the living quarters, I would definitely get that. Maybe wait until it goes. I'm sure we're going to get like 30, 40% off of the upgrades here eventually. So just keep it stock. Other than living quarters and workshop. Okay, so now you own your HANGAR. You know which location to do. Now what do we do? Now the first thing you may think is like, okay, there's a person here now. You see this? We can run over to him just like we can do with the special cargo warehouses, and we can have him source cargo for us. Now, you're not going to want to do that, especially during these double money weeks, because you want to get the same type of product so that you can maximize it. Let me throw this up on screen right here. So as you can see, the narcotics is going to give you a 70% bonus. So that's the one we're going to go for. Now, I know what you're thinking. Like those... Excuse me, Dom. I'm in the middle of something here. Bugger off! I know what you're thinking. Medical, chemical, and narcotics all give you 70%. So could you just do source one narcotics, one medical, one narcotics, one medical? That way you can skip the cooldown. The answer to that is no. You have to have 50 of one specific thing. So for me, I'm going to be going for narcotics, so I can't have anything else. So if I was to source something from good old Rooster McCraw right here, that unless it was narcotics, which the chances are going to be, you know, one in what? One in eight? So I'm not going to risk it. So I wouldn't use him unless you're just, you know, outside of trying to fill this thing all the way up and you just want to get some. But I wouldn't do it. So next up, once you've, you can see I have nothing, which is perfect. I have absolutely no cargo whatsoever. That is perfect for this video because I'm showing you how to do it. So makes sense. So what we're going to do is run up here over to your left. That's going to be your house. That's going to be your living quarters if you purchase it. So that's where you're going to spawn in. And then right here is going to be your office. Now, when you come over to your office, you can see you can register as a CEO or an MC president. Whichever one you want is the one you should go for. I'm going to go for, We'll go for MC Club President just so I can make sure I can use that oppressor mark too. There you go, President. And now here we are. You can see total stock 0 out of 50. Now I want to get all 50 the exact same thing in order to get that 70% bonus. So what you're going to want to do is go to source. You can't go to sell just yet because as you can see, we have absolutely nothing. We're going to go to source cargo. Now, narcotics, or you could go for something else. Let me throw this back up on the screen right here. You could do any of these, counterfeit, jewelry, medical, any of these. If you're planning on filling it all the way full though, I would obviously go for medical, which is this one right here, chemicals, this one right here, or narcotics, this one right here. These three, doesn't matter which one you go for, just go for one of them. That way, if you're filling all the way up, you'll get the 70% bonus. Now, if you're like, I don't have a lot of time, I'm just going to fill up 10. Well, as you can see on this right here, if you have 10, what's got the biggest bonus right here? It's going to be jewelry, art, or animals, so go for one of those. But like I say, for the sake of this video, I'm going big or going home, baby. We got 2x pay this week, so I'm going to be doing this multiple times this week, and I recommend you guys do too. So we're going to go, first things first, narcotics. Select, how would you like to source it? Or are you sure you'd like to? Yes, but we're going to go for land. And believe me, land is the one you're going to want to go for. It is by far the fastest, easiest way to do it. So let's go ahead and click land. All right, here we are. My oppressor is actually already perfect right outside here for me. So this mission is La Mesa. So what I'm going to do, La Mesa. I don't know why that was so difficult for me to say right there. So let me speed this up until we get there. And I'll just show you this first mission. And then after this first mission, I'll give you some tips on the other missions, because they're all pretty much the same missions. So I'll just give you some tips on all of them. But for this one, I'll show you exactly how I do it. So let's speed this up. All right, so here we go. This is far enough ahead here. I will say this is one of the most far away missions you can do, just FYI. So don't worry, they're not all going to be this far away. So for this mission, you're going to shoot this box right here. It could be on the left-hand side, could be on the right-hand side. So we're just going to go, oh, wrong button. I pressed boost instead of shoot. My bad. All right, so what you're going to do is just shoot at this thing right here. Now, that is broken, which is going to open this door right here. And since we're using the oppressor, all you need to do is drive in here. You should be able to pick this thing up right there, just like that. And then fly on out, boost out of there, and there you have it. That is literally it. If you don't use an oppressor, let's say you use a sparrow, you can just get off, go in, and then get back in your sparrow or buzzard and fly away. But obviously, for a mission like that, this is by far the best vehicle to do it in. It is a little bit slower than a sparrow to get around the map, but it just makes that part a lot easier. So that's it. Now, it looks like you can see people like on the red dots on the map. They're not going to get you. They're on the ground. You're flying. Now, we're just going to head on back. So let's speed this part up. And all right, here we are coming back up. You can see as of right now, that has taken us about 4 minutes. And that is one of the most furthest away missions you can do. And that was 4 minutes. I don't think I could have done that any faster. And then we drop it off right here. And that is it. That is one cargo done. Now, you only get one per mission. You can't get two or three like some of the other businesses. It is one per mission. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to put a timer on my phone just so I can be completely transparent with you guys, so you know exactly how long it's going to take you if you're trying to do this yourself to fill up the entire bunker. Is it going to take us an hour, 2 hours, 3 hours, 4 hours, 5 hours? I'm going to tell you. But what I am going to do is I'm going to record so that I can show you. So this part right now, let's skip ahead, and I'm going to give you some tips on some of the missions you're going to come up against. One thing I did want to mention, let's say you do this with friends and you invite them to your club and you do it together, you can source more than one crate. Obviously, depends on how many friends you have with you. You can source multiple crates to speed this up, but then you're probably going to have to do it for them as well to make it even, so it's going to take about the same amount of time. But if they want to just do it for you, then you're golden. All right, so now that we've delivered our we've sourced our very first crate, if we go into our menu right here, you can see sell, we've got one narcotics. And if we go to source more, there is the three, I think it's a 3.5 minute cooldown. So you do have to wait. And this is honestly the longest part, is having to wait for this. Now, like I say, if you did chemicals, you could select this and then complete that, then come back to this, click that, and just keep going back and forth. But you're not going to get that 70% bonus. But tomorrow I'm going to be showing you how much you can make an hour doing it that way. So make sure you're ready for tomorrow, because that's going to be a good one. What you'll get if you do it that way is you'll get 35% bonus on each of them. Okay, so now that it's cooled down, I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to set a timer on my phone. I'm going to show you guys some tips and tricks on some of these missions. And this is the thing. And tomorrow's video, what we'll do is I'll do the back-to-back. So I'll do this one, this one, this one, this one. And I'll show you the difference in pay and the difference in time. So once you've seen this video, watch tomorrow's video doing it this way, and you can make the decision yourself versus do you want to spend less time and make X amount of money or spend a little bit more time and make X amount of money. We'll be doing that today and tomorrow. So let's go ahead, start the timer. All right, one of the first tips I have for you is the mission where it says go to Sandy Shores. Now, when you head over there, you're going to just look in the sky for a helicopter, and it can be in one of three locations. I'm sure you all know the three locations it could be in at this point, but you don't have to kill anyone or the helicopter. All you need to do, and this works, I have done it. Right now, I'm recording this part when I'm editing this video, so I've already done all 50 of these, and I got this mission, the Sandy Shores one, maybe 15 times, and 100% of the time I did this mission, you can always see the crate on the floor glowing. You don't need to get off your oppressor, you don't need to kill anyone, just head over to the crate, you'll see it glowing, grab it, and then head back. It is that easy. So for the infiltrate the deal missions, there's about three or four locations it could be across the map. This one that I'm doing right now just happens to be the most furthest one away. But any of them, all you need to do is fly over there, blow up the trailer with your oppressor mark 2, and again, the cargo will fall out next to it. You never need to get off your oppressor, pick it up, and then fly it back. So for any of these ones where you have to go on the barge and then the submarine, they are the longest ones. There's like three or four different locations it can be. It's kind of a pain. But what I did this time, since I was using the oppressor, I just flew straight over there. I landed on top of the barge. I killed everyone there. And then I made sure that I put the oppressor into storage. That way, once I got the cargo with the submarine and drove it to land, all you have to do is blow up the truck again. The package will fall out next to the truck. Then you can spawn your oppressor mark 2, pick it up, and fly back. All right, and just like that, I've registered as CEO, because as you can see, we're in a full lobby. And it doesn't look like there's any bad people in here. Let's take a little look at the map. No one's around here, which is actually surprising. Looks like they're all going to be... Well, the majority of them, obviously, as always, are in the city. We've got someone in a plane right here. Keep an eye on him. But for the looks of it, it seems like a pretty decent map. Or a pretty decent lobby, I should say. So the first thing we're going to do, I'm going to show you what I have. I mean, I already told you what I'm getting, but we'll show you. But the first thing we need to do is get our truck. So what I'm going to do is go to vehicles, and I'm going to request our Phantom Wedge. Now, that's going to spawn over there. So what we're going to do is just go to services, Kasaka. Let's just grab our Sparrow real quick. Should spawn right next to me. All right, and now we're just going to head on over to the Phantom Wedge. I hate that the weather's like this. Absolutely soul-destroying. All right, and here is our Phantom Wedge. Let's go ahead and pick this up. So the other thing I'm looking at, even though... Don't you hit me, NPC. NPC is the most dangerous thing in this bloody lobby, I'm telling you. So the thing that I'm looking for is looking at the kill feed. And as you can see, since we've been driving around here, we haven't seen anything going off in the kill feed. So that's a good sign. That's a good sign. Especially since there's not one person that's like killed 10 all at once, because that means it's most likely a modder. So we're going to take this over to our hangar. So the reason we're taking this to the hangar, by the way, is because if we're doing a ground cell mission and we want to make sure that we have a Phantom Wedge to be able to carry the trailer around, if that's the vehicle that we get, because otherwise it's going to be just a pain, to be completely honest with you. Because if you don't have a Phantom Wedge, you want this because it's just more armored. It's easier to get through traffic. So we're just going to put it right here. That way this other guy who's in here doesn't mistake it for his. And I hope this weather clears up, man, because driving around in this rain, it is bloody slippery. All right, so you can see all of our product right here. It was empty earlier today. So we're going to run upstairs and show you what we've got, how much it's worth, all of that. And then the first thing, though, is I'm probably not going to sell it until this guy leaves. It looks like he's already left, got into his little vehicle here. As long as he doesn't blow this up, it looks like he's not. He's leaving. Okay, he's leaving. So one more quick check. It looks like we are good to go. There's an oppressor over here. We'll ignore them. Okay, let's take a sit down here real quick and go over the product. All right, so as you guys know, 50 out of 50, and all of it is in narcotics, which means we have a 70% bonus, as you can see down here. That is 5.1 million, and I'm just going to do it. We're just going to do it right off the bat. We're not going to worry about anything. Land vehicle, please. We're not going to stress. This is probably the most stressful sale mission you can do because it is massive. It's double money. But we're going to run out here. First thing we're going to do, we're going to ignore that phone call. Oh, it's this. This is one of the worst ones. I can't even use my Phantom Wedge that I have parked right there because we have a 10 out of 10 delivery. Now, I've done this before with the... If we would have got one delivery truck, it's always one vehicle, by the way. Oh my God, this thing isn't even strong enough to break through that fence. It's always one delivery vehicle when you do a land sell mission. But it could be this, which is by far the worst, just because you have to deliver 10 things and it's in the city, I'm guessing. Yes, it's right in the middle of the city. Now, if we had the Phantom Wedge, it would have just been one truck we would have had to deliver. But we would have NPCs chasing us, which does damage your goods unless you kill them. So that can be the only downside to that. But the Phantom Wedge would have helped out tremendously. And like I said earlier, I'm hoping the rain clears up because driving around in the rain, you're slipping and sliding all over the place. And we're doing it in this with bloody over $5 million worth of product on us. But as you'll see inside of a full public lobby, this is going to be a lot more than 5 million. So anyway, let me speed this up until we get to our first delivery drop. So one thing I will say while we're driving over here, you can back out of the lobby right now. I could literally go to another invite-only lobby and try it again, and I would get a different sell vehicle. Now, the only thing with doing that is you'll lose 3 of your product. So instead of having 50, we'll have 47. So that just means we'd have to fill up 3 more crates, which obviously is probably going to take you about 30 minutes, to be completely honest with you. So is it worth it getting a different sell vehicle to make your life easier? That decision is up to you, but it is a possibility if you don't want to drive around in this bloody hump of junk. So the weather has cleared up, as you guys can see. It is no longer raining, but there is a lot of water left on these roads, which means it is still super slippery. So, okay. Still super... Can you... I don't want to run you over, my guy. It's still super slippery. Okay, so let's go ahead and deliver that. Now I'm going to go into here. Hope there's no one up here. And here we go. So if you follow the blue markers, which is what you're supposed to do, it should make your life a little bit easier. But I, for one, seem to never follow these markers. But I'm going to this time because last time I completely made a stinker out of it. And I couldn't find where we were going. You know what? We're just going to go up this way. But sometimes they can be underground, is why I'm saying that. If they're underground, it may look like you're confused. You're like, oh my God, where am I supposed to go? But if you do actually follow the markers, it does lead you underground. Which hopefully it'll be one of those here today and I can show you. But either way, we'll figure it out here together. All right, on to the next one. So far, so good. Let's not go too crazy, though. All right, here's another blue marker telling us we need to go down here. And there it is. So far, so good. Like I say, I'm not holding my breath because there is people around us. But they're being good. Like I say, this lobby has been pretty decent so far. Like, looking at the kill feed, not too much going on. So we're going to hope that it stays that way. All right, here we are coming up to number 4. There is people in these buildings, but that's because it is their CEO office. So we're going to just assume that they're being nice. The reason I'm putting these markers down is just in case, you know what I mean? All right, the next one. We're going to go through here because I'm assuming this is the way that it wants me to go. Even though I don't see any more of those blue little flyers anywhere. All right, never mind. Oh my God, this thing, even in the dry, bloody ground, this thing is the worst controlling vehicle, I think, in the game. I hate it so much. So much. Oh my God, it doesn't even bloody brake or slow down or anything. All right, deliver that one. All right, on to the next one. If you guys remember, the last time I did this, okay, we're supposed to go this way. I do remember this from the last time. But if you guys remember the last time I did this, it was, we did get attacked like halfway through by some random person. So I'm hoping that doesn't happen this. I'm going the wrong way. This thing's lying to me, man. Absolutely lying to me, telling me which way to go. I'm going this way. There it is. All right. The good thing about putting your marker on like I'm doing is also you can see the map for a brief second and see if anyone's around you. And as you can see, we haven't had anyone around us. Excuse me. Listen, you're in the way. Okay. I'm sorry. You should move. Open your eyes. Look what's around you. All right, on to the next one. These are the one good thing about these delivery missions is they're all close together. But if there's people knocking about in the city, you're going to be screwed. Actually, I think it was this way. I think I had to go this way, if I remember rightly. You got to go up in here. Yeah. All right. And the last one is going to be right down here. I guarantee it. But we'll figure that out in a sec. All right, here's number 9, and let's see. Is it going to be where I said it was? Sure, bloody is. All right, so for this one, you can see we still have 25 people, so we're still going to get the high demand bonus. You've got to go on this side of the rail, because I have been on the other side before and messed up. And what I would recommend is do like a... See if you can skid and go in backwards like this. Because if you don't, when you try and reverse, you'll run into that and you'll get stuck on it. So just FYI. All right, now let's leave the area. All right, so it should be coming any second. There we go. $7.6 million. Now, I think that is actually less than last time. I'm pretty sure last time we had a 2x pay. I'm not sure why. I'm pretty sure it was like 7.8 million. But I'll take the 7.6 million. This vehicle, though, can bloody go to hell. I hate it. See you later, loser. All right, let's get back to our hangar real quick. All right, so 7.6 million was our nice payday right there. Now, let's put this into perspective. So to fill this thing all the way up, in all honesty, I think it was about 6.5 to 7 hours. So with that being said, you're making, what, about 1.1 million an hour. Maybe 1.1, 1.2 million an hour, which is actually really good. So what we're going to be doing tomorrow is we're going to be testing some other ways to do it even faster and see how much money we get that way. Because would you rather do it like I did for like 7 hours to get the 7.6 million? Or would you rather do it in half the amount of time and not get that much less? It depends. What's worth more to you, time or money? We're also going to be checking out some of the 4x pay things this week tomorrow. So make sure you subscribe with notifications on for that to see if it's worth doing. If you have any questions, make sure you leave them in the comment section down below. I will try to respond to every single comment. If you have any questions, I'll try and respond to every comment anyway. But I hope you enjoy the rest of your day, and I will see you guys. That is a beautiful plane. Stop looking at it. I will see you guys tomorrow, as always, with a brand new video. Goodbye.